Solomon Schechter Day School of Bergen County, we are in the process of changing how we teach and how we learn in our middle school. We are becoming an international baccalaureate program. We wanted to find a way to make the middle school experience more holistic, more integrated. Typically, IB involves integration across different academic disciplines, but we're taking it one step further. Our challenge is to stretch the IB approach across a dual curriculum. We are utilizing IB as a way of demonstrating to students how relevant the study of ancient Jewish texts really is, that it helps them to see and understand that their Jewish learning is inherently connected to their secular subjects.
Change is exciting.
Hard.
Interesting.
Scary.
Necessary.
Inevitable.
Challenging.
Rewarding.
Fresh.
Gratifying.
An IB unit starts with a key concept, which is a big idea. IB has 16 key concepts. Each subject focuses on a few of the concepts, and certain concepts get taught across different subjects, such as the concept of change.
This year in math, we learned about scientific notation. Scientific notation is about changing small and big things into numbers that you can more understand, or big and small things. So for an example, a star that's very far away, to help you more understand how actually far away it is, the scientific notation helps you see how far away it really is.
This year I learned how to change a verb from present to past tense. Ani lamadati ech lashanot po'al mehoveh le'avar.
Lately in my science class, I've been learning about the process of nitrogen and the nitrogen cycle. And basically, these things, which is nitrogen, are floating all around the room and are all around us, but we can't use them because they're too hard. And as you can see here with this model, if I pull on it, I can't break it. But there's bacteria that can break it by taking apart its triple bond, which as you can see here are these lines. And the process of that is called nitrogen fixation. And as they're breaking it, we can finally use it. So the nitrogen has to change in order for us to be able to use it.
This year in design class, my grade took on the challenge to try to make the library a better place and to change it so the children would want to come to the library and to be more excited to come no matter what age they are in. So we had an interview process where we had to interview little children, and we got a lot of information of what they liked about the library and what they thought that could be improved. We took all that information in, we used all of that to try to think of an idea to make the library a better place.
In Tanakh, we learned about Sefer Yonah. Yonah was a man who was told that he had to go to Nineveh by God, but he didn't really want to change what he was doing, so he ran away. He realized that change was hard, but sometimes change is the right thing to do. This year, I was told that I would have to share a room with my little sister, and I was very upset. And I told my dad that she should sleep in the living room because I like my own space. But he told me that change was a good thing sometimes. And I actually enjoy sharing a room with my little sister because she's very cute and I get to give her a kiss at night. We've learned about change in the water cycle, the nitrogen cycle, changing fractions to decimals. But this year we learned how to change in humans and how they think about change. In Judaic studies, we read Tanakh and Mishnah, and even though these texts are really old, they can relate to our lives, and sometimes they really help us learn to change.